Today on Fatmann Makes, we're going to take a look at the Pwnagetty script by CirrusXD. It was designed to work with your Pwnagotchi. It downloads your handshakes and then processes them, getting rid of any that are invalid. Make sure you subscribe to the contest by sending me a pwn mail, details in the description. And don't forget to click subscribe and ring that bell so you get notifications of upcoming videos and details on the contest. Hey everyone, welcome to Fatmann Makes, and today we're going to take a look at this Pwnagetty. What is a Pwnagetty? Well, honestly, I don't really know. There was a couple posts from SiriusXD, the subreddit, and on the Slack channel saying that, you know, he was working on a way of extracting your pcap files and then encoding them, making them easier for you to crack. So I'm going to take a look at it. So the first thing we need to do is see if we have bash installed. So we'll type bash in the command prompt, and says you don't have a Linux subsystem installed, here's the link. So if we paste that link into the browser, we can now open it in the Microsoft Store. You have a different flavors of Linux here. I'm just gonna pick Ubuntu, and we'll do a quick install of this. So get it, and no thanks. And then we're gonna click install here. And then it's going to download and install. We'll speed this up so it does actually take a decent amount of time. And then we can say launch. So it's going to go through its post-install setup here. So you have to define a username. We'll put Jim. And then we need to set up a password for the environment and confirm it. We get a confirmation that the password was updated and the install was successful. Let's take a look at the Pwnagetty GitHub page. Right, on the GitHub page, we see that there's a list of requirements here that need to be installed for this to function. So let's open our Ubuntu environment. And if we jump into this Node.js link, we can see here's the instructions to do an install. We can copy this and paste it in. Let's add a sudo, type in your password, hit enter. And this install does take a bit, so we'll just speed that up right here. And once that completes, then we need to do this next command, sudo apt-get install -y node.js. Hit enter, let that install go through, and when that completes, we're going to get this package update. Use the keyboard to go over and select yes and hit enter. This will allow it to finish the install. Once that completes, we'll jump over to the Aircrack NG installs. So we click on installation here on the left, and then we're going to pick the pre-compiled binaries. From pre-compiled binaries, we can see in the top here the release. So select release, and that'll give us the curl command that we can run. So let's dump that into the terminal. And once that's complete, then we're going to do a sudo apt-get space install space aircrack-ng, hit enter, and we'll say yes to install here. Once that completes the install, we'll jump back to the Pwnagetty GitHub page and we'll run the installation here. So we copy this git clone command and execute it. Well, let's do an ls. Okay, so the Pwnagetty folder's there. Let's change directory to that with a capital P. And the next command is this npm install, hit enter. And then again with the dash g, we probably should run this as a sudo. Yep, we got an error, so let's do it again. Sudo space npm space install space dash g. And enter. We're gonna jump to this HCX pcap tool. So we click clone, download here, and copy this text. And we're just gonna do a sudo git space clone and then paste that text, hit enter. And that should clone the HCX tools and create a folder in your directory. And then we see here, we just have to run a make and then a make install as a super user. So I do a sudo make here and we get an error stating make is not found. So we need to do a sudo apt-get install make, hit enter, and let that install complete. And we again test it, sudo make, it still doesn't install correctly. We get a couple error messages. After looking into these error messages, I determined that we need to do this sudo apt-get space install space build-essential. Hit enter and let that install. All right, so once that installs complete, then it says here, install these requirements. So we'll give that a shot. Let's just copy that out, put a sudo in front and paste that text, hit enter. And we'll say yes here to install these packages. Right, so once that's complete, we can do a sudo space make. And then when that finishes, we need to do a sudo space make space install. All right, at this point, I think we have everything actually installed and should be functional. So we just need to configure Pwnagetty here. And it gives you this file that you need to edit. So we'll do a sudo nano to edit that file. And then we can see here that this handshakes directory is actually the directory on the Pwnagotchi, which I overlooked originally. So I'm updating that to be /handshakes. Everything else for my individual device is the same. So we're gonna save it. All right, so I'm gonna back out of this subfolder I'm in, and then we are going to just run the Pwnagetty script and hit enter. And if you did everything correctly, it will connect and then it'll show that it's downloading the pcaps. And right now it's actually processing everything. Once it finishes processing, you'll get this message that it's all done. And if we take a look at the folder structure here, we can see that there's three new folders, one called HCCAPX, one called PCAP, and one called PMKID. I did message SiriusXD, the creator of Pwnagetty, just to get a little more details in regards to what his script does. So he indicated that he's concentrating on the PMKID files. So if there is a handshake and a PMKID, he throws out the handshake and keeps the PMKID. Pwnagotchi does perform both the handshake attack and the PMKID attack, but it seems to concentrate mostly on the four-way handshake attack. The other issue is that some APs may not respond to the PMKID attack, so the only way to get that information would be through the four-way handshake. But what does this mean for us if we are actually cracking these files? So what we're looking at here is results from this multi.pmkid file. So this is a compilation of a bunch of pmkid files that were created from the Pwnagetty script. And we can see here that it shows you the cracked password, but we have a hash of the SSIDs. It doesn't actually give us the SSID, and in my mind, that's an issue. Okay, so let's take a look at the HCCAPX files that we got from the Pwnagetty script. Now again, this is a compilation of multiple files from that script, and we can see here, when it performs the crack, we get the password and we also get the SSID. And in my mind, that's a big benefit. Obviously, you need to know both to utilize that information in any real way. Again, it depends how you're utilizing these files after you convert them. So I am using Hashcat, and Hashcat's preferred file is the HCCAPX file. So that is another benefit of actually utilizing that file structure. So my personal preference would be to have all HCCAPX files, because the PMKID file, again, is missing information that I feel I would want. One other issue is that having two separate types of files, then I have to run two separate crack sessions instead of just utilizing one session on a larger group of files. So what do you guys think about the Pwnagetty plugin? Have you tried it out? What do you like about it? Let me know in the comments below.